Hi guys, welcome to my channel and welcome to today's video. I hope you guys are having an awesome day today. So today's video is going to be my low-buy haul for the month of January. If you guys don't know, I am on a year-long low-buy and I have done a video on that. So if you are interested, you can check out that video to know more about it. Basically for like the entire year, I cannot buy more than 4 products in a month. And there are some other rules and exceptions. But I have not been sticking to the rule very well. Like this month also I have extra products. Last month also I went on the holiday, I had few extra products, but I'm hoping that in the future I will do well. But my low buy is going pretty good. I have been thinking a lot before purchasing something. Earlier I used to just go ahead and buy it, but now it's not the case. I think I have controlled myself really well, but my rules wise I'm not doing that good. So I will let you guys know in today's video what are the products I have purchased in the month of Jan. And this video I have done a little bit differently than the previous one. In this video I have tried on the products so that you can see how it works. So it's sort of like a first impression as well. So most of the products are on my face right now. So if you guys are interested to see what are the products I have purchased in the past month of January, then please continue watching. Well guys, let's get started with today's video. So I will do this video in a little bit of a different style. I will use the products on my face. I haven't really used these products a whole lot, so this is not exactly a review. It's sort of like a first impression which I'm doing. And more reviews, maybe I'll do a separate video or I will put it up on the blog post. So yeah, let's begin. I have already prepped my face and I have already applied my base makeup. I have done my foundation and everything. I will list all of the products in the description box. I always do that. So the first product which I purchased in the month of Jan, rather I ordered these products towards the very end of December. So I am considering them as Jan purchases because I actually got them like towards the middle of January. And these products I purchased just because they were on sale and I have been wanting to get these for a really long time. So I'll just let you guys know which are these products. This is from the brand Dose of Colors and I purchased 3 things from Dose of Colors. The eyeshadow palette, I got one highlighter which I will show you and one lipstick which I will use in the video. Right now let's go ahead and see the eyeshadow palette. I have actually not swatched this eyeshadow palette yet. I have just a little bit like touched and felt the shadows how they are, but I haven't done a look or anything like that. So this is like a totally first impression. This is how the palette looks like. Look at the packaging. This is the outer box and the packaging is just so beautiful. You have all the shadow names behind, and I think for a large part of December, and I don't know if it's true even now, but for the large part of December and January this was on sale. So Dose of Colors were having a lot of promotions. This I got for 30% off. This was also was 30% off, and the lipstick also. Now the lipstick I added to my cart just because I wanted to get free shipping. Otherwise I wouldn't have purchased this lipstick. So this is like I had to order. So I will explain about the lipstick later. Anyway, so this is the palette and this is how it looks from inside. It's actually really beautiful. When it first came out, I did not pay a lot of attention to it because it looked pretty neutral to me. But the shadows, which are the shimmer shadows which are here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there are 5, like these are not shimmer, these are like metallic glittery foiled finish. Like this shimmer here, it's a bluish purpley duochrome sort of a shade. This one is like an olive green, and then you have this blackened shimmer. So today I think I will go here and do sort of a smoky look and see how it goes. So first of all, I'm going to prime my eyes with some primer. Okay, and I think I'm going to use these colors for my transition. This one. They are really beautiful mattes. I don't know how these mattes are. I haven't swatched them or touched them even. So let me just do this shade first as my transition. I will not explain too much what I'm doing. First thing I notice is that it blends beautifully. It is just appearing a little patchy here because I haven't set my primer. So probably if I had set my primer, it wouldn't look patchy. But it's okay, we're just trying the product out. This is not a review. I think the shadows, they will blend beautifully. If I set my primer, like the top part, if I set it, they will just blend so beautifully and they are really nicely pigmented. That's my first impression. The mattes, the matte brown shade which I'm using, really really nicely pigmented, and it showed up very well. I haven't really built up too much. Let's use a little bit of this color now. I'll just use the same brush since we are just trying out the palette, and I'll just take this a little bit and wow, this color is beautiful. I never thought I will buy this palette because I was never interested in it, and but I heard so many good reviews. People are just raving about this palette, how good the quality is, and I think I have a sense why people are raving about it, because the glitters or the shimmer shadows I have seen, I have swatched a little bit, they are really really beautiful. But the mattes I'm just trying out for the first time today, and they are also working really really good. Let me swatch some of the shimmer shades. This is that blue purple shade. Look at how the pigmentation is. This is so beautiful. And this is the deeper green shade. So pretty. And it has, these have like a duochrome glittery shift. All of them have some sort of like a shimmery glittery effect or a duochrome. My favorite of the palette is this one, this olive green color. But today I'm not going to use that because I think I have done a look recently with olive green and gold. So I will not do that look. So beautiful. These kind of shades I just love. I have some color on my eyes finally. I think I was looking dead with just foundation for so long. Okay, now I will apply this blue. I just can't help myself. I just use this blue all over my eyelid, and I will just use my fingers. I used the other blue by mistake. Never mind, it's okay. Oh my god, this is so pretty. This blue is gorgeous. I think towards the outer V, I will apply this deeper blue a little bit. This is like a deeper bluish, blackish sort of a color. And I'll just use that on my outer V. Wow. Okay guys, I'm back. I just got a little too involved. I actually used most of the matte shades here. I used this one, I used a little bit of this one in the outer V as well to deepen up. Then I used a lot of this one in the outer V and I intensified with this blue a little bit. I thought I was just going to do a little bit of a try on, but I went pretty deep and it's now a full blown eye look. I have applied liner, mascara and kajal, and I think this look was really really easy to do. I think I have used all of the shadows here right now except this one and this olive green. The olive green, I know it's going to be good. I can feel it. I still need to test out these two shades and then I can tell you guys my final thoughts. But I think this palette is just great. It's a bomb palette, especially the mattes. They just blended so beautifully. It's so easy to do such a blended smoky eye, and I just love the quality of the mattes. These two shades are so so good. The mattes did not have any fallout. With these two shades there is a little bit of glitter fallout, not exactly fallout, there is a like little bit of specks of glitter here and there. So if you do your eye look first, I think you should be okay. So yeah, that's my first impression of this palette. I think I really really like this palette. It is so beautiful. So that was the Dose of Colors Frankation palette by Desi and Katie. Next up, thing which I purchased from Dose of Colors is this highlighter. This is the I Love Sorahi Dose of Colors highlighter in the shade Bath. Now I wanted to get this highlighter for such a long time. This is how the outer packaging looks like, and the reason why I wanted to get it is because I felt like this shade would be really really nice for my skin tone, and I have heard really good things about the formulation of these highlighters. All of the products from this line have this leafy packaging. I really love it. So let me just give you a quick swatch. Where should I swatch it? I have like glitter here, but let's see. It's intense. Oh my god. I have actually not worn that highlighter even once. Okay, this is the highlighter. Okay, let's see how it works out. I will probably wear it in some other video and show you guys. I hope it's not too stark on my skin tone and too white. Somehow it felt like it will suit my skin tone, but now I am not too sure. I almost feel like putting a little bit on and seeing. Let's just do that. Let's put a little bit on. I'm really, really curious. I haven't applied this yet. Okay, it's quite intense and it's not a subtle highlighter by any means, but I think it's suiting my skin tone pretty well. Like if I look here, there's nothing, but if I turn my head around, you can see the highlighter. That's my first impression of the highlighter. Okay, and the other product which I got from Dose of Colors is this lip shade. This is their Satin Lipsticks Lit It Up Satin Lipsticks, and I got the shade Lava Cake. I already have one of their lip shades. This is the shade Cinnamon Swirl. Now, I hate the packaging of these lipsticks. This bullet doesn't go down, so when the cap is, when you have to put back the cap, you have to be very, very careful. This is how the shade is. It's a really, really pretty peachy nude sort of a color, but I feel like I would have loved if it was a little bit deeper. So that's why I got this shade, that since I was ordering from the website, I thought I'll just pick up the same lipstick formula in another shade. So I got the shade Lava Cake, which is a little bit deeper. I'm always scared of this. So this is the shade Lava Cake. This is the shade Lava Cake. Wow, that's a beautiful, beautiful color. Okay, can we tell that I already love this shade, and the formula of these lipsticks are so good. They just glide on the lips. They are super creamy and they stay on the lips pretty well. Being a satin lipstick, they are not like they fade away very quickly. They are pretty long wearing, and I love this lip color. Now let me just top it up with a little bit of the cinnamon. That was my intention of buying that deeper lipstick. So just at the center. I think it looks perfect. What do you guys think? I just love it. You guys know how much I love nude lipsticks, and I think this combo looks great. So those are the three products I purchased from Dose of Colors. My low buy quota is four products. So my fourth product is this one from Colourpop. Of course, we need to have one Colourpop product at least. So this is the product I purchased from Colourpop. I have always wanted to get one of these bigger pan palettes which they have. Now this is your build your own palette from Colourpop. They were having the promotion of build your own palette, where you can take a custom palette and fill it up with shadows, and the entire palette was 50% off. And I was like, I want to get this because I have always wanted to get more Colourpop singles. I don't have many Colourpop singles. I have most of their palettes, but I've always wanted to get their singles, and this is a very, very good way to do it. If you are into, if you are looking into Colourpop singles, then just see when they have this build your palette promotion. They have quite often, so that time you can get this at a very, very good price. So I got this palette at 50% off. I did not pay more than $50 for this, and the original price is like more than $100. So these are all the shadows I put in my build your palette. Now for my low buy, I consider palette as one single product to make my life easier. Different shades of lipstick, the same lipstick formula is also like one product to make my life easier. So this is the fourth product which I have purchased, and look at all the colors which I have put inside. These are beautiful Colourpop singles, and I fill it up mostly with duochromes and shimmers sort of colors. Some mattes are there here and there. I think six mattes are there. Rest are all duochromes and shimmers. They are so gorgeous. I have already written a blog post on this. I hope I already have that up on my blog. If I have it, I will link that in the description box so that you can go ahead and check out the swatches. I will be swatching everything on my blog with names and everything. So that was the fourth product I purchased. In fact, I have ordered something from Colourpop, but I don't have it now. Just towards the very end of January, Colourpop released their It's My Pleasure palette, which is like the purple palette. I will show it in the screen here. I don't have it right now, but it's coming. I think they haven't shipped it yet, but yeah, I'm really, really excited about it. And I told you guys on Instagram that I might break my low buy for that, and I did break my low buy for that, and I'm not sorry. I am super excited for that palette to get here. I don't know when it will get here, so I'll just add it in my February haul. So I think I will have to purchase less products in February. I can't go overboard. Okay, it's not over yet. I have one more product. I have purchased one more product, and I'll let you guys know why I purchased this. And this I have been eyeing since the day it launched, and I knew I would get it. It was like I wanted to get it, and I purchased it because it's a limited edition product, and I did not know how long it will be there. So for limited edition products, I don't know, I want to be a little bit flexible. So that's why I went ahead and purchased it. So this is the Becca collaboration with Chloe and Malika, and I got the deeper palette. This is basically a face palette which they have launched. They have released two versions. One is for fair to medium skin tone, one is for a little bit deeper skin tone, because Malika is on the deeper skin tone side. So I thought if she has designed this palette, it will work on me. So I got this deeper palette. This is the face palette. It has one bronzer, two blushes, and one highlighter. This is how the palette looks like. It's so, so beautiful. And I was hoping that this bronzer will work on my skin tone, and it does. I got my Too Faced bronzer also here. This is the Too Faced bronzer. Somehow I feel the Becca bronzer is a little bit deeper as well, so it should work on my skin tone great. And there are two blushes. None of the blushes are matte. They are shimmery, satiny blushes, and one highlighter. I'm excited to use this highlighter. So let's dig into this product and use a little bit of this bronzer first. Okay, I love the packaging of Becca products. So, so beautiful, sturdy. It opens flat like this. I love that. It's very, very easy to hold. I have held it like this. I have applied highlighter already. Then I'm applying bronzer. So I think this palette also, medium skin tone also, will be able to use nicely. If you're medium skin tone, maybe you should go for this palette, because the lighter shade I saw in Sephora here, the bronzer seems pretty light. So if that doesn't work out, you can probably try out this palette, deeper one. Bronzer can be built up very easily, and it just looks very, very natural, seamless on the skin. I just try to build it up and show you guys. I don't bronze that much. Like, I prefer a very light bronzer. But just to show you guys, I will build up a little bit more and show you. I'm using the Real Techniques contour brush. Sometimes I use that for bronzer. You can use a bronzer brush also. Okay, I think I'm done bronzing. I love the bronzer. It looks very natural and works great on my skin tone. Let's apply some blush. Now with this eye look, I preferably wouldn't apply that much blush, especially not shimmery blush. But since this is just a try on, I will apply one. I think this with this eye look, we will go with the more cooler one. This is a little bit more corally and warmer. This looks a little bit more cooler. So going in this shade, I'm using the Zoeva Premier brush. It is one of the newer brushes. I have been getting a lot of questions about this palette, so I'm glad I'm showing it to you guys. See, it's a really, really pretty blush. With this blush, you wouldn't really need highlighter. You can just wear this blush and that's it. Wow, this is so beautiful. Like a glowy blush. It's very, very smooth. And there was a time when I did not used to like glowy blushes, but I think nowadays I am really into glowy blushes. I think they give your skin such a nice healthy glow, and this one is not like very shimmery, chunky, glittery or anything. It's just smooth sheen. Love it. Really, really nice. And we'll apply a little bit of highlighter too. I will not apply this side, I will apply on the other side. The highlighter looks really, really pretty. It's like a champagne-y golden sort of a color. I'm just so happy with this Becca product. And Becca quality is always beautiful. It has a lot of glow on the cheeks. But nonetheless, I can see that the highlighter is right here. It's sort of a golden peachy highlighter. Very, very good for our kind of skin tone. So I don't know, I feel like my first impressions, I like this highlighter a little bit better. What do you guys think of this extra glowy makeup look? I think I'm done with this palette. Not anymore, I don't want to apply anymore. I have too much glow on my cheeks and too much glitter on the eyes and just glossy lips. I'm just glowing. So that's the fifth product for Jan. And I also got one more thing, but that is not part of my low buy. I mean, I am not restricting myself in this category. I got some new lashes. These are from the Nikia Joy Cosmetics. Nikia Joy is an Australian YouTuber. She's quite big. She has around 700k followers. I don't know if you guys follow her or not. I really find her very entertaining. And she does reviews and she is quite honest, I feel like. And I love Australian accent, so I love watching her. And she has her own cosmetics company. She has launched some lashes mainly. So this is her latest line, which is supposed to be the naked line. And the lashes are supposed to be invisible. So I'm quite intrigued. I wanted to use it today as a part of this get ready with me. I can't find my lash glue. I don't know where I have kept it. So we will reserve this for another video. But this is how the lashes look like. They look really pretty. As in, she has designed them to be very natural looking on the eyes and not appear too lash-like. But there are some dramatic ones here. So I don't know what about I'm going to do about that. But I like these first two, three. And they appear a little bit bigger as well. So I probably will have to cut it and measure it. And so we'll not go into that much hassle today. But I got this. And yeah, I'm quite interested to try out. I'm in the hunt for natural looking lashes. And yeah, with that I have come to the end of today's video. Those are all the products I have got. Let me know which product you have been eyeing and which product you got. I know some of you are also going on a low buy. Which are the products you bought in the month of Jan? Please let me know. And yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this get ready with me. If you did, please let me know by a thumbs up so that I can do more of these kind of videos. I will be posting a review of all of this on my blog anyway, so you can just check it out there. So yeah, that's it for today's video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys really soon in my next video. Bye.